For decades, the autoimmune disease called lupus has been one of the greatest challenges known to medicine. It affects millions. Its impact on all aspects of patients' lives is nothing short of catastrophic. And listen to this, about 90% of its victims are women. As for a cure, all medical efforts have failed to find one. Today, we're going to share what could be one of the biggest medical breakthroughs of our time. First, let's learn about lupus from autoimmune disease clinician and researcher, Dr. Yvonne Scherer, and one of her lupus patients, Althea McKenzie. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having us, Olga.
Althea, let me start with you. How old were you when you were diagnosed?
I was 25 years old.
And how did that change your life, dear?
It significantly changed my life because my life is not my own anymore.
And that makes a huge impact on just what you do. For example, I know we were talking and you can't drive?
When I'm not well, I do not drive.
And I don't even think you can go out in the sun, right?
That's correct. You have to wear sunscreen, have an umbrella, and also have your car windows tinted.
I know you were a model, you were a runner, you were doing so many things that I'm assuming then just...
totally stopped.
Emotionally? Physically, spiritually, what did that do to you?
It's very depressing, a lot of anxiety, a lot of fear. Your life is just not your own. It is controlled by how you feel and how your disease is at the moment. So if you're not feeling well, you're not gonna go anywhere. You're afraid to go anywhere because you might get sick.
And doctor, let me bring you in quickly. A lot of people hear lupus, and what is it and what does it do?
Lupus is an autoimmune disease. That is, the immune system is turned against itself. Instead of attacking a virus or bacteria, it's attacking your own tissue. And that can be manifested in a host of different ways. Every organ in the body can be affected, from the brain all the way down to the toes. You can get rashes, sores in the mouth, swollen lymph nodes, arthritis, just every organ can be affected.
And I was reading here, Althea, and I know you experienced all those symptoms that
That's
the doctor
correct.
Was mm-hmm. describing, but you can't work?
No, I do not work.
You live with your parents, I believe?
That is correct.
What about your social life, finances?
My social life is limited depending on, you know, how I'm feeling. And finances is just, it's a strain because so much medication, so many medical bills, and not working, my income is limited.
Suffice it to say that it's paralyzed your life, if you will.
It is correct.
Doctor, let me bring you back in. From a treatment perspective, why is this disease so challenging?
Well, for a number of reasons. One is because every patient is different. And one patient may respond to a drug, another patient won't respond to the same drug. And now, in this current healthcare system, is getting the drugs paid for mm-hmm. because there are very few drugs approved for lupus. And so when we have to use unapproved drugs that will save people's lives or at least help, often we can't get it covered.
And I want to go back to the statistic here. 90% are women.
Yes.
Okay. And now, when it comes to age and race, is it anyone or is it a certain race, a certain age?
Anyone can get lupus.
Okay.
Male, female, any race. However, having said that, it's more frequent in women of childbearing age, and it's more frequent in women of color. African American, Afro-Caribbean, Hispanic seem to have more frequent disease and more severe disease.
Are there symptoms to look out for?
There's no specific symptoms.
Okay.
Women can just have fatigue and just not feel well, or they can have a rash and arthritis. But you can't be limited by symptoms because people can present very differently.
I can only imagine what a cure would mean for you and for so many millions of people out there.
Definitely getting my life back and being in control.
Well, today we're going to talk about hopefully getting your life back, medical breakthrough. So stay right there, please, ladies. And coming up, an exciting medical breakthrough in the fight to cure lupus. There's hope here this morning, isn't there?
Yes.
Yes. So stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone. We're talking about one of the most devastating autoimmune diseases in existence, lupus. An astounding 90% of its victims are women, and until now, there's been no cure. But listen to this. Our next guest truly believes that's all about to change. Joining us now is Miguel Sealer from Neovacs, the French laboratory that says it's closing in on a cure for lupus. We're also rejoined by lupus expert Dr. Yvonne Scherer and her patient Althea McKenzie. Miguel, encouraging. I want to hear what this new treatment is because we've heard from the doctor what lupus is. We've heard what it's done to Althea and millions of other people. What is this new treatment and how does it work?
This treatment is a therapeutic vaccine which enhances the immune system of the patient to give the appropriate response to the disease. Mm-hmm. We enhance the immune system to produce self and polyclonal antibodies. And these polyclonal antibodies will neutralize the protein which is produced in excess by the immune system and which therefore has produced this disease. So by having the immune system of the patient giving the appropriate response, we think we are on the right way.
So you're using, and from what I'm hearing, and clarify for me, that you're using the patient's own immune system to fight the disease.
Exactly. That's what we call active immune therapy. That's to say we do not administrate a drug, a foreign body, against the immune system could eventually develop antibodies to fight the antibodies. We program the immune system of the patient mm-hmm. to produce the appropriate response to the disease.
Clinical trials going on right now?
Yes, we have a phase 2B trial going on 166 patients in Europe, Asia, and Latin America. And we plan phase 1-2A trial in the US in the upcoming year.
Doctor, how do you feel about this one?
The potential for this drug is just phenomenal. It'll be safe, not immunosuppressive, effective, and tolerable. And I tell you, if it holds true to that, we will just rejoice because it's been a long time coming. In the last 50 years, only one drug approved for lupus, and that drug isn't immunosuppressive and does have some safety issues, where this drug may not have those same issues.
Miguel, when might this be available here in this country?
It's still a long way. We have to admit that.
Okay.
We are in phase 2B in many countries of the world, but I guess for being available in the United States, we still have 3 to 5 years in front of us.
Althea, I see you looking at Miguel. I see the face glowing, a smile. What would this mean to you? And I'm sure you could speak on behalf of so many people out there.
It would be like winning the lottery.
I can only imagine. For information on this new treatment and anyone out there who may have lupus, Miguel, where do they go to? What's the website?
Just go to neovacs.com.
And I do want to let you know that because of a wonderful dance teacher that we have for the children, we actually partake in the lupus walk every year. My girls and I, you see them right here, and they even are creating that awareness. Althea, really important, creating awareness and finding that cure, right?
That is correct.
Thank you so much for being here. And for information on lupus, where do they go?
They can go to lupus.org.
Good luck to you. And I want to promise from you that when this treatment comes out, and I have a feeling this is going to be a winner, you come back and let us know.
I definitely will.
And I want to hear that you're modeling again and going out and going to the beach and doing all the things you want to do.
Definitely.
Yes, God bless you. Thank you so much. Doctor, thank you for your time. And Miguel,
you're
we
welcome.
Look forward to having you back. Hopefully in the next few years.
We work hard on that.
Thank you so much. And of course, if you'd like more information on lupus, head to lupus.org, or you can always go to our website, thebalancingact.com. There is hope here.